my name is Mrs. Campbell. What we're going to do today is we're going to discuss how to create a professional portfolio or portfolio, in fact, for college. Remember, you need to research, inquire, and render your compositions. You need to be sure that the universities that you choose are your top three, so make sure you get your top three schools that you are considering. We also want you to think about how you must submit this to requirements for this to grades, your ACT, your ACT, and what the college requires. Be sure to speak with your counselors at the school, your art teachers or professors, and make sure you submit exactly what's required according to the institution. That's why we research our top three colleges. We also want to make sure that we understand that you need to also, you also take tests. These tests will be like still life compositions, different type of media, acrylic, watercolor. You will also be required to submit some of these pieces that are considered your instructional pieces, meaning they want to look at that and see how far you have advanced. Now, the requirements for the universities, like I said before, will all be different. They may be digital, they may be hard copy, they may be both, meaning another leather portfolio along with a digital copy. Now, you will see here samples of college entrance portfolios, and I want you to notice one particular thing about the portfolios. They are very neat. The artwork is extremely clean, so make sure when you do these that you are really prepared for this, because studio art is 100% of your grade when you're attending an art institution for visual, fine arts, graphic design, photography, whatever that particular art field may be. They will require still lifes. They will require different types and forms of artwork. So be sure that you review the requirements very carefully. And make sure you take great photos of the work. So when you submit these pieces have been, the photos have been taken in a well-lit area. And there are no cast shadows other than the ones that you rendered yourself. Here's some more pieces of different portfolios. Look at the beginning and the ending process. Some of the portfolios have images on both sides, some do not, but you must work diligently in order to prepare these portfolios. Now, preferably, your portfolios will normally have information about the artwork on one side, and on the other side have the actual artwork and its label. That's normally the normal setup. But again, you will do exactly what that particular art institution requires you to do, and do not lay away from it. Do exactly what they want you to do. That way you are meeting all the requirements. Be sure to get multiple letters of recommendations. Make sure your resume is simple but effective. Be sure to make copies of your digital work as well as your hard copy work in order to give them, the people who are interviewing you, the art committee, so that way you're not surprised and they're not surprised that you don't have these. And you may also want to take these portfolios or take the pieces in the portfolios and mat them. They look very professional when you mat them, but again, make sure that's okay with the institution prior to doing this. Then make sure in your preparation for your portfolio you create yourself a check off list. Make sure you've checked off everything, and then remember to have your art teacher, have art professors at your local university to actually critique this work and get this work back to you so you can see exactly how you're doing. Don't assume anything, because the art schools are very, very particular about what they accept. Most importantly, we want you to look at a rubric. They will have a rubric located in the information for you. So be sure to check off your rubric to make sure you've included everything that they want you to have, because they're going to actually rate your work according to a rubric, excuse me, similar to the ones that you've probably already been graded on while in high school. So when you create these rubrics, be very careful to pay close attention to exactly what they want, the dimensions, meaning the size, width, and depth, and if they will accept any 2D or 3D work that may be protruded from the page. It just really depends on what you're doing. Now, I want to leave this quote with you, which I think is very, very nice. I'm not sure who wrote this. I found this, and I think it is very, very important. It says, art education is like a tropical sunrise, and the sun, the sky, and the water, palm trees, dock, and the ocean, everything plays an important part in your life. It plays an important part in your work. Everything has rhythm, because we know art is the basis of